begin responsibilities. That's a sentence written in 1937 by an American writer, Delmore Schwartz. The responsibility of the idea, the dream, to develop an European doctoral program in career guidance and counseling for PhD students began exactly as a dream, when a group of scholars, researchers, and practitioners put aside their own dreams to create a common one. Probably because the new ideas in terms of counseling and in terms of guidance became urgent in order to help people to survive without losing the sense of individuality. Because of that, people need people well trained, well prepared to help them to surpass the violence of a society that put economic and political interests at the first floor, at the same time put people at the basement with precarious conditions, threatening the dignity of the human. In that sense, it is our responsibility to squeeze from theoretical all the possibilities for training doctoral students. For that, it is clear to me that we need a strong and powerful integration of the theories in terms of guidance and counseling, as Jérôme told us a few moments ago. The only way to transform the dream in realities, or in other words, to prepare the program in guidance and counseling for doctoral students, try to give to those students a macro perspective on community needs, but also a micro perspective on individual needs. So, I think that one of the possible points to think a doctoral program, the structure, is consider the level of intervention and at each level consider modalities of training. And I will quote part of a report from the seminar on a national system of lifelong guidance for Portugal. The seminar occurred in Lisbon in 2011 and originated a report named Lifelong Guidance Discussion, Reflections and Considerations, signed by eminent scholars, Vanesbroek, Guichard, Mark Savicas, and three Portuguese colleagues, Janeiro, Paula, Paixão, E. Taveira. So, and the report tells us the levels of intervention. And because there are big differences in these issues that people face and the competencies that they need to master them, there are also important differences in the interventions that professionals can provide to them to help people design and construct their lives and careers. Three possible levels of intervention may be distinguished. And I quote, the first level of intervention is mainly about information. These interventions help people construct a clear idea of today's work and jobs, and also of the curriculum and trainings that prepare for these jobs. This kind of information aims to helping people answer questions like the followings. What major activities does one do when one exercises professional function? How is work organized? How are the working conditions? What are the perspectives of employment in this professional domain? And so on. So the intervention of this first level is mainly of educational nature. They don't imply that clients enter into an important work of reflection on themselves and their experience, although they predispose them to make it. And for this level of intervention, what is needed? Training for thinking global, acting local. Prepare trainees looking for information. What for? For the future. Because future experts need to be prepared to training other professionals like teachers, employers, social workers, and other professionals. Experts in guidance and counseling must know how the future clients can assimilate information, the methods, and the tools that can be used in the field of information. And the second level of information, and I quote again, may be called psychopedagogical interventions or guidance interventions. Their intention is to help clients create or develop some specific ways to relate to themselves and to the various experiences in relation with some analogous ways to relate work activities. Here, the object is not, as it was the case in the intervention of the first level, to familiarize clients with the major aspects of today's work, training and recruitment. And the core object of these interventions is about the competencies that are required to do such or such work functions, as we see in the blue book published by the NICE network. The competences that clients involve in such interventions have already constructed. So, the bilan de compétences or some career education workshop may be seen as prototypical examples for this kind of intervention. And for the second level, what is needed? Training for thinking global, acting local. Programs of career education are a good example of a diversity of guidance practices in different parts of the world. But the theoretical support are in general the structural and development theories involved in the mainstream of career guidance. If we take into account, at the same time, personal and contextual career determinants, the career model may provide a good framework for the provision of guidance in developed countries as well as in nations with developing economies when a global economy prevails instead of a social or global education. Brief, doctoral students need to receive a theoretical and practical training in vocational psychology, and Jerome announced, in my opinion, the main theories and issues in this point. But allow me to emphasize this point. In order to foster the development and delivery of adequate guidance in various settings over the next 10 years, it is imperative that we give attention to the challenge that lie ahead, namely, the provision of guidance must take into account the changing nature of work. The transition periods are more time-consuming for guidance practitioners, for example. And the third level of intervention emerges, and I quote again my colleagues, because psychopedagogical interventions or guidance interventions fundamentally deal with knowing how and knowing whom issues. They only approach marginally the question of knowing why. That is the question of a meaningful life, and more particular, the topic of works integrations in a life that makes sense. End of quotation. And for this first level of intervention, what is needed? Training for thinking as a co-constructor. A comprehensive and fundamental approach on counseling needs some more pillars framed by a theoretical framework where the concept of counseling emerged. Life designing counseling may be seen as a comprehensive and functional perspective on counseling that constitutes the theoretical framework where the concept of co-construction emerged. Co-construction is the ability to achieve success in a dialogue, success for both the counselee and the counselor, given one's personal standards within one's social-cultural contexts. It is the ability to capitalize strengths and compensate weakness. Co-construction is based on an ideographic definition of success, not a nomothetic one. Co-construction is recognizing that counseling is always social produced. Co-construction emphasizes that counseling does not only promote an adaptation to contexts, but also involves shaping. That means modify the context to suit oneself, and sometimes selection in order to help finding a new context that is a better match to one's skills, values, or goals. Co-construction is facilitating interaction with the real world, helping to create, helping to invent, helping to imagine, helping to discover. Co-construction is a teamwork where the possibilities to analyze and to use to design a life shared the same time, the same space, the same reflection. In that way, training to be effective needs to be learner-centered. That means student must be involved in the designing of the training. Training must include different learning styles. Training must align with policies and practices. Psychological perspectives on training in terms of find a solution should integrate, evaluate adaptations the individual makes to the environment, promoting in that way the competencies of planning, the competencies of decision making, the competence of exploring, and the competence of problem solving. It will be important to specify the components of knowledge acquisition and the level of experience needed for this knowledge, in the for example, in the negotiation of events, and the adaptability by which individuals maintain identity while dealing with change. So, at the end, indeed, in dreams begin our responsibilities. As Saint-Exupéry wrote, place no hope in a man if he works for his own lifetime and not for his eternity. And I think that we are bartering our souls for something greater than ourselves. Thank you very much.